T-bones, porterhouses, ribeyes, Delmonico's, filet mignon, New York strips, sirloins. There sure are a lot of different names used to describe just a few steaks. But did you know that they all come from the same part of the steer, from just three muscles? The longissimus muscle runs along the spine, making up the eye of both the rib and short loin primals, the large cuts of beef from which steaks are fabricated. The short loin also contains the psoas major, or tenderloin, and the rib contains the spinalis dorsi, which caps the longissimus. These primals yield the most tender and flavorful steaks. This is because the muscles contain sedentary tissues that are used only when the animal turns, resulting in fibers that are finer than those found in motion muscle. The rib primal gives us rib steaks, sometimes called a cowboy steak, and the boneless variant ribeye, often called a Delmonico, named after the famous New York City steakhouse. And the rib steak with an extra long bone? That's called a tomahawk. The short loin yields strip loin steaks because the tenderloin has been stripped away. You may see it on the menu as a New York strip, a Kansas City strip, or even a sirloin. The psoas major, or tenderloin muscle, spans the strip loin and the sirloin. It is separated from the longissimus by the so-called finger bones that run perpendicular to the backbone and form the distinctive T-shape. When both muscles and bone are cut into steaks, they give us T-bones and porterhouses. The porterhouse has a much larger tenderloin section than the T-bone and is further back on the short loin. Because porterhouses tend to be larger, you will often see them on the menu for two or three people. Finally, we have the tenderloin, which is the most tender cut on the steer. Cut into steaks, it is called filet mignon, or served whole for two people, it is called a chateaubriand. So now you know where the most tender and flavorful steaks come from. You can't go wrong with any of these, but if you want my opinion, get the rib steak.